Hello all, welcome back to the VTV Shikshana program. So today in this particular session, we'll take up again the application of digital circuit, especially the circuits for arithmetic operations. So this topic introduces the concept of using a sequential circuit to control a sequence of operations in digital system. Such a control circuit outputs a sequence of control signals that cause operations such as addition or shifting to take place at appropriate times. Okay, so whenever any operation has to be performed, it is controlled by the control signals. Okay, that is the meaning over here. So we will try to illustrate the use of control circuits by designing a serial adder, a multiplier, and a divider. So in the next three sessions, including this, so we'll try to design a serial adder, and next a multiplier and a divider circuit. Okay, the very first we will take up is the serial adder with accumulator. In this particular section, we will design a control circuit for a serial adder with an accumulator. Figure in the next slide shows a block diagram of the serial adder. This is what the block diagram it looks like. Okay, we'll come back. Two shift registers are used to hold the 4-bit numbers to be added, X and Y. The X register serves as an accumulator and the Y register serves as an addend register. Okay, so if you just look here, there are two register, predominantly a shift register kind. So this is my X register and this is my Y register. Y register acts as an addend register. X register, initially it stores the input value, and finally the added version will be stored in the accumulator. So initially accumulator holds one of the operand, and at the end of the operation it will store the result. That is what we have. When the addition is completed, the contents of X register are replaced with the sum of X and Y. And this is what just now I told. The X register, initially it will hold the one of the number, and at the end of the operation, it will hold the sum of X and Y. The addend register is connected to a cyclic shift register so that after shifting 4 times, it is back in its original state and the number Y is not lost. Meaning this Y, initially it contains the addend, that is the second number. After the 4 shift, okay, it's a kind of cyclic, okay, because Y naught after the right shift 1 bit will go to Y3 and something like, since it is a cyclic shift register kind of circuit we have. So after the end of the operation, this addend register value doesn't change. It will retain or remain the same as it was before the operation. Okay. This is what we try to have this. So it is a serial adder. We will add a bit by bit. Okay. And the result will be stored in the accumulator. Yeah. And as I said, these are the two shift registers to hold X and Y value. Okay. So since we are adding serially, so we need one full adder. One number being the X, another number being the Y, and CIB is any carry. So initially we let the carry to be 0, and later stages, whenever we add any 2 bits, whatever the carry is there, that becomes the input over here. And the sum will go and sit always in the most significant bit of X. So after the result, okay, so we'll have the result in the, after the operation, we'll have the result in the accumulator. And this entire thing, and this particular D flip-flop is used in order to store the carry out, because in the next particular adding operation, we require that. Okay, so this D just ensures that whatever the carry we get after any 2-bit addition, that will be stored for the next operation to be successful. Okay. So this is the serial adder circuit. This particular portion, what you can see in the blue color, is a serial adder, these two being the register, and then we have one control unit. Okay, and the clock is given for both this. For every clock, okay, or this register is synchronous with clock along with the control circuit. So control circuit and these two registers are in synchronous with the clock. So for every clock pulse, the registers and the control signals is enabled. And then you can see that this control circuit has a start signal, and one of the output signal it has SH. SH is basically a shift for us. Okay, so this particular serial add and then storing starts or begins only when we initiate the control circuit with the start signal. When start B signal becomes 1, then depending upon the clock, then we'll try to add. Anyway, we'll try to show in the next slide how exactly this addition happens now. Okay, so this is what is all about. And after every addition, then we'll try to shift. And whenever the shift is enabled by the control circuit, then only there will be a right shift that is happening. Okay, so this is what the circuit is all about. Okay, so this is the block diagram for serial adder with accumulator. And here is what 5 different cases, okay, at different time, what you mean, right? At time T0, at time T1, at time T2, at the time T3, and at time T4, what really happens, okay? So what we are trying to do is, okay, initially, okay, so we will try to have, okay, as I said, this being my, just a minute, 0101 and 010111, okay? So this is the initial content of X is 0101. Okay, and the initial content of Y being 0111. Okay, initial carry, anything is there initially. Okay, we'll take that particular thing to be something like 0. Okay, so initially carry in is 0. So typically what we have 2 numbers X and Y, with X being 0101 and Y being 0111. And what is that CI we have considered? It has to be 0 initially. So when I try to add, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1, 2. 2 in binary is 1, 0. 0 will come here. 1 will go as a carry from the least significant bit. And in order to hold this carry, we need this D flip-flop. That's fine. Then 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is again 2. 2 means it is 0. This is 1. This is the carry out from the second most bit. Then this is 1. And finally, this is 1. This is 1100. Okay. So after we add 7 plus 5 is how much? 12. And this is what we have as 12. Okay. This is my 12. This is my 5. And this is my 7. Okay. So 7 plus 5 is total 12. Okay. So now, after we add, okay, after the sum or the adding operation is complete, this accumulator initially, which holds the one of the value, finally it will hold the result or the sum of 2 things, that is 12. Okay, so this is initially, and after the T4 timing, I should hold, or this accumulator should hold this. Okay, so now I can say that initially or at time T0, okay, X naught value is 1, Y naught value is 1, and initially we reset my flip-flop. So initially the flip-flop contains, or the content of D flip-flop is 0. That means it is reset. So at time T0, we say that CI is 0, YI is Y naught, that is 1, XI is X naught, that is 1. So XI is the serial in, YI is the serial in for full adder. SI is the sum that is coming out. CI plus 1 is the carry out that is coming out. XI always will take the X naught value. YI always will take the Y naught value. Okay. This is what. Okay. So with this, we'll go with the very first time, at time T0, in the next slide. You can see that. So we'll analyze at time T0 what really happened here. Okay. So as I said, X naught goes always, X naught is the value that is going as an XI, Y naught is always going as a YI. Okay, so this is what X naught initially, as I said, this was my 0101, this was my 0111 initially. Okay, I have enabled the start signal. And then something. So initially, this is getting 1. This is getting 1. Okay. This is what really. And this is my 0. And you can see here in this particular table shows of operation of serial adder. At time t naught, x value is 0101, y is 0111, ci is 0, si is 0, and this is what we'll try to see. Okay, so now this is my xi, this is my yi. 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 0, 2. 2 means sum will be 0, carry out will be 1. Okay, so that's why my sum is 0 and carry out will be 1. With the initial carry zero, this is what really happens. So meaning now the least significant bit of x and y are now added, and whatever the carry that is coming out, okay, which is one, that will be stored in this particular flip-flops, okay, in the next clock pulse. Yes, and if I see here, this is what initial value, this stored. Okay, next, once this particular bit is added, then the control circuit will trigger the shift along with the clock. Yes, when it does the shifting, the serial input that is coming for Y3 is Y0, output of Y0 is coming for at every shift, Y3 will be taking Y0 value. Okay, at every shift of X, X3 will be taking the SI value. Okay, this is the simple thing now. Yes, X3, this is the serial in that is coming. This is something like serial in, serial out with respect to shift right. SISO with respect to shift right. Okay. And shift is enabled by the control circuit. Whenever the shift happens, so after every clock pulse, when this addition happens, then there will be a shift parallel. Okay. So at time T naught, we added X naught, Y naught value along with CI, initially zero. We got sum and CI plus one. Sum is connected to serial in with respect to X3, and Y naught is connected to Y3. And CI plus one with this one. So you can see that clock is synchronous for all these things, D, X register, and Y addend register. Okay. So now, after the first one, okay, then there will be a shift enabled. Okay. Shift enabled means there will be a right shift that is happening here. Okay. The moment the right shift is happening in both these cases, is this one. Once this, so this bit will move here, then X2 will be moving to, okay, so what they are showing is X0 is going and sitting here. Okay, so I'll just change here in this particular thing. When I do the shifting, X1 will come and occupy X0 position, X2 will come and occupy X1 position, X2 will come and occupy X3, and whatever the sum that was coming out, that will be coming here. So we added the least significant bit first, X0, Y0. That's why S0 is coming and occupying. So this is typically my X3, X2, X1, X0. After the first shift, I got this to be 0, 1, 0, and whatever the sum we add, that will come and sit here. You can see that there is a one bit right, one bit shift towards the right. So that's why the 010 will come and occupy here, and whatever the sum was there, that is coming and occupying here. Okay, and this is my Y3, Y2, Y1, Y0. You can see that Y1 is occupying this space. Okay, so previously Y1 was 1, that's why now it is, this becomes 1, this is 1, this is 0, and this whatever is there, that will go in. Y0 was initially 1, this is. Okay. So after shift right by one bit, this is shift right by one bit, we'll have something like this. Yes, always Y3 will be occupied by Y0, X3 will be occupied by the sum bit, and then we'll have one more. Okay. Now, at time T1, after one shift, after the first LSB added, then the shift, we have something like this. X is having this, Y is having this. That means X1 is 0 now, Y1 is, Y0 is 1, C1 is what? Previous it was 1, that's why this will be coming in. Again, my sum is 0, carry is 1. Okay, CI is this one now. Okay, so this was the case. My got sum 0, carry 1. Okay, and this sum will go and sit here. So that's why you can see that this becomes 0, this is 0. Okay, this is 0, this is 1. So now I am shifting this entire thing by 1 bit, means this bit will go 001 is there, 001 will come, and the sum bit will be occupying here now. Okay, and what about this? It is just a shift, right? Circular shift. This 0 will come here, 1 will come here, 1 will go here. It is 1101. This is 1101. What is my C2? C2 is 1 again. So C2 will be 1 here. Y2 is 1. X2 is 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1. S2 is 1. C3 is 1. Okay. So in the next cycle, I get this to be 1. This to be 0. This to be 0. And this to be 0. So I have one shift, two shift, and the third shift I am making. And in this case, it was 1101. Now it will be 110. It is 1110 with C3 being 1 that is carried out here. This is 0. This is 0. This is least significant bit adding. This is X2 adding. This is X3 adding. And this is X0, X1, X2. Here I will be adding the X3. Okay. 001. So I get sum to be 1, carry out to be 0. So you can see that sum is 1, carry out is 0 at time T3. So here I've added 4 bits in serial, starting from least significant bit to that one. Okay. Then after this, I have to shift. Okay. This one will come here. And these 1001 will move towards right, and that will be 100 here. And what about this content? This 0 will come here. This will be 111. Okay. So as I said, Y will hold the initial value Y only, you can see here. Yes. And the X, which was holding one of the value initially, now it is holding the result or the sum. Okay. And whatever we get at the unused, this is unused at the final thing. Okay. So this is, I'm least worried about after the four shift. Okay. So this is how exactly we try to do or operate the serial adder with accumulator, where one of the register is acting as an accumulator itself. Okay. This is what really happening. And then depending upon T0, T1, T2, T3, and depending upon X and Y, what should be my sum and what should be my carry, that we are going to decide. Yes. Yeah. So this is what we'll try to look into this particular serial adder with accumulator once again. Okay. So two shift register are used to hold 4-bit numbers to be added, X and Y. The X register serves as an accumulator and the Y register serves as an addend. The X register, initially it will hold the number and finally it will hold the result. Okay, and that's what is predicted here. The addend register is connected as a cyclic shift register so that after shifting 4 times, it is back in its original state and the number Y is not lost. Okay. So here we try to use two register X and Y. Y stores the addend register. After the summing or operation is complete, this will hold the initial value and this will hold the result sum. And this is a full adder that is used to add 1 bit each because it is a serial adder. Okay. And this D register is used to hold the carry out that has to be fed as an input for the next clock pulses. Okay. And this is a control circuit. Once we start, then depending upon the clock pulse and then this shift operations, it will be shifted. So at time T0, it is the least significant bit we are adding. Okay. Along with the initial carry is 0. We reset the D flip flop. And after adding, whatever the sum bit that will come, that will go and sit here. That's why we have shown it as S0. And there will be a right shift happening. X3 will come to X2. X2 will come to X1 position and X1 will go to X0 position. Is that okay? Yeah. So this is what really happens now. And similarly, Y is a cyclic shift register. Y0 will go and sit in Y3. That's what is happening here. And then Y3 will come and sit in Y2 and Y2 will come and sit in Y1 and Y1 will come and sit in Y0 space. And this, after each addition, there will be a shift, right? Okay. There will be 4 addition and 4 shift. First add, then shift, add, then shift, add, and then shift finally. And this is what we really get it. Okay, so from this even we can come up with the Mealy sequential circuits. So we'll continue in the next session.